Just because I'm a calculus teacher, a lot of people like to ask me, when is the best time to take the derivative? Well, let's take a look. Right now it's 3:20, and here we go, that's the answer. And we will be differentiating the product of these two integral functions. And as I told you, we will make derivatives cool this year. So here we go. This is the product, so of course use the product rule. I'm going to keep the first function. So we will have the integral going from 1 to x squared, and then we have 2t over 1 plus t squared dt. And then we will have to differentiate the second one. And to differentiate an integral function, when you have a number to a function, all we have to do is plug in this function into the t and use the chain rule from there. So we will get 1 over 1 plus, replace the t with ln x, and then we still have the parentheses to the second power, and then use the chain rule, multiply by the derivative of that, which is 1 over x. And then we can continue. We are going to add the second function, which is the integral going from 1 to ln x, and then we have 1 over 1 plus t squared dt. And then again, same thing. We are going to just plug in the x squared into the t and also the t here. So we are going to get 2 times x squared over 1 plus x squared and then square. And then we have to multiply by the derivative of x squared, which is 2x. So when you do this, this is technically called the fundamental theorem of calculus part 1, along with the chain rule, all right? So that's how we differentiate integral functions. And I know you guys want me to actually figure this out. I will, don't worry, all right? So let's do this in our head though. To integrate this, notice that the derivative of the bottom is precisely 2t, so this is just integrating 1 over u, right, in the u world, after you do the u substitution, letting u equal the bottom. So we will just get ln of 1 plus t squared, like so. And notice, I didn't put down the absolute value because everything says positive. And then we just have to go from 1 to x squared. And check this out. This part, we just have to plug in and plug in subtract. So we will get ln of 1 plus x to the second and then to the second. So that's to the fourth power. And then minus plugging 1 here, work that out, you get ln 2. So this is really that part. And in fact, if earlier we were going to figure this out first and then do the derivative, we will still have the same answer. And that's why we don't need to worry about the number. Check this out. The integral is this. If we differentiate this function, the derivative of ln of 1 plus x to the fourth power is 1 over x to the fourth power, 1 plus x to the fourth power, and then multiply by the derivative of this, which is 4x to the third power. We do have 4x to the third power, all right? And then the derivative of the minus ln 2 is just 0. That's why we didn't need to worry about the number. All right, and then perhaps we'll clean this up a little bit. How though? I don't know. Let me just, perhaps I'll just put him down here then, I guess. Yeah, so that's the first part. And let's go ahead and do the same thing for the second part. All right, do this in your head. Let u equal this, which is just going to be integrating 1 over u squared. And if you do that, you get negative 1 over u. So this part is negative 1 over 1 plus t. All right, so just integrate that. And then just plug in 1 and ln x. So we are going to get, let's see, plugging ln x first. So we get, okay, and then we have some denominators. So I'm just going right here. So we have negative 1 over 1 plus ln x, and then minus, and then minus, so become plus, and put a 1 here, so we have 1 half. So work that out, you will get that, and then the rest. And again, if you look at this and do the derivative, you will end up with this, and you will end up with this. But anyway, work this out, we get 4x to the third power over 1 plus x to the fourth power. And yeah, I'm just gonna stop right here, why not, huh? Nothing else that we can do. Double check, triple check. Let me see. You can try combine the fractions, get the common denominators, but we are all adults now, it's not necessary. Unless you have to find the maximum of this function, so maybe you will have to set equal to 0. In that case, maybe you have to combine all the fractions and set the numerator equal to 0, but I'm gonna leave that to you guys. Alright? Anyway, that's what I have for you guys today. What do you guys have for me though? What shall we differentiate next? Leave a comment down below and let me know. That's it.